Hello friends, welcome to Bootstrap video tutorials series. In this video tutorial, I would like to discuss Bootstrap form related classes. We understand how do we create forms in Bootstrap step by step. I minimize the word. I double click on my first Bootstrap site folder to open it. Inside my first Bootstrap site folder, we have created default.html page. I right click on it, say open with the notepad. You can see that default.html page is open inside the notepad. It has the basic HTML5 document structure code. Title is set to Bootstrap demo and we have linked necessary CSS and JavaScript files. In the body section, I am going to create a form. To create a form, we take help of form tag. I say here opening form tag and closing form tag. To this form, I apply a minimum height of 100 pixels. To do that, I say here style min-height of 100 pixels and I add a border of 1px solid gray color. File, save. I minimize the notepad. I right click on default.html page, say open with the Google Chrome. You can see that default.html page is open inside the Chrome. Title is set to Bootstrap demo and the form is created. It has minimum height of 100 pixels and it has a border also, you can see that. Let me set the width to 50%. So I go back here. I say width of the form should be 50% of its parent. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that the width of the form is reduced to 50% and I align it center. To do that, I say here margin of auto semicolon. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that form is horizontally aligned center, right? Inside the form, I am going to add form controls. First, I ask username. So what I do here, inside form, I add a label tag, opening label and closing label. Here, I am going to ask username. I say username colon. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that username colon text is displayed. Next, I am going to display a text box. So I say here input type is equal to text. By default, the value should be empty. And we are going to link this text box to the label by saying here for txt username and the same value we will be using inside the name attribute. Now I can access this text box inside JavaScript using this name attribute value txt username. I can say here id txt username. I can access this text box in CSS using this id attribute value. I can also access in JavaScript using this id attribute value. And then I say here close. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that the text box is displayed. At present it is inline level. I want to convert it into block level. To do that, we take help of form-control class. Form-control class is used to convert textual input controls into block level controls. Form-control class is used to convert textual input controls into block level. So I go back here, I say class form-control. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that now the text box is block level. If I click it nicely, get highlighted, right? It is getting highlighted, you can see that. Next, I want to add some padding around the form content. So what I do here, I say padding of 10 pixels. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that the padding is added here. Now we are getting the username. So user can enter his name here. Okay. Let's get the password. So before getting the password, I want to group this label and the text box. In Bootstrap, we have form-group class. It is used to group related labels and controls together. Form-group class is used to group related labels and controls together. So what I do here, I'm going to create a div, opening div, and then I say here closing div. Here I'm going to add a class of form-group. Form-group adds little bit margin. If I say file, save, go to browser and refresh, you can see that the space is added here below. Next, we take password, as I told. So I copy this form group div, paste here. I copy this closing div tag and paste here. Inside that, I'm going to add a label. Here I say password, and here I say txt password. Next, I say here input type is equal to password, value should be empty, name should be txt password, and id should be txt password. Close it. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that the password text is displayed and we have the password field. Let's convert it into block level. So I go back here. I'm going to copy this class and paste here. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You see that the password field is created and it is block level. Here user can enter his name. Here user can enter his password. Right? Next, I want to ask email ID. So what do, guys? We'll create one more form group. Copy that and paste down. I say div, paste down. I'll say label in this place. I say email ID. Here I say txt email. And then I say here input type is equal to email. By default, value should be empty. And the name should be txt email. I copy that and paste here. ID should be txt email. Close. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that email text is displayed. I want to convert this field into block level. So what do, guys? We copy this class equal to form control and paste here, right? File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that email field is now block level. Here user can enter his email ID, right? @gmail.com, like that. Okay. Next, I want to ask the gender of the user. So what do? Same as usual, I create a form group here, paste. I say here closing div, I am going to copy and paste, and inside that I am going to add the label, copy that and paste here. So we are going to ask gender. Here gender we are going to get with the help of radio buttons. So I say here rdb gender, txt for text box, rdb for radio buttons. Okay, it is just a prefix value, guys. Of course, if I say file, save, go to browser and refresh, you see gender colon text is displayed. Next, we are going to display radio button and male, then radio button, then female. So what do, guys? I'm going to create here radio button. To create radio buttons, we take help of input type equal to radio, and the value will say here M for male. When we submit the form, M will be sent if user select the male radio button. Then the name should be RDB gender. I copy this and paste here. ID should be RDB male. Close. And then for this radio button, I need to create a label. So I will say here label, opening label and closing label tag. And inside that I say male text. and then I say here for, this label is for RDB mail, that is radio button which is created for mail value. Next thing, in Bootstrap we have form-check-input class. It is used to stylize the radio buttons and checkboxes. So to this radio button I am going to add the class form-check-input class, and to this label we will be using a class form-check-label. You can see that we have form-check-label class. It is used to stylize associated labels of checkboxes and radio buttons. We also have form-check class. It is used to group related labels and checkboxes, or related labels and radio buttons. So what do we do here is, we are going to add another div inside, opening div here and a closing div. To this div we will be adding a class of form-check. So form-check class is used to group related labels and radio buttons, or related labels and checkboxes. So here we are grouping the label and the radio button. Okay, I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that the mail text is displayed, and it's a radio button, you can see that. Next, I want to display female. So to display the female, what I am going to do is, I am going to add a form check again. So I copy this div class and I paste here form check. I say closing div, and inside that I am going to add a label. I copy this and paste down. F for female, the name will be RDB gender. RDB female will be the ID value. Next, I am going to copy this label and paste down. So this label is for RDB female, and here I am going to display female text. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that the female radio button is also created. Male, female, male, female. I say refresh. We can have by default one radio button checked by saying here checked, checked attribute. So this radio button will be by default checked. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that the mail radio button is by default checked. Next, I want to ask hobbies of the user. So what do we do for that? We will be creating a form group again, form group, and a closing div I say here. Inside that I am going to add a label. I say here hobbies, hobbies, hobbies. We are going to get hobbies using checkbox, because user can have more than one hobbies, right? So I say here chk hobbies, and then I am going to add form check. Copy that and paste, and then I say closing div. Inside that we are going to add a checkbox. To create a checkbox, we say here input type is equal to checkbox, and then value I'll say M for music. Then I say name. Name will be checkbox hobbies, and the ID I'll say here chk music, and we will be using this class form check input to stylize this checkbox. And then we need a label for the checkbox, so I'll paste that here. This is for chk music, chk music, and we use the class form check label here. And here I say music. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that hobbies is displayed and music checkbox is created. I go back here. Again, I am going to copy this form check div. I say here closing div, and I copy this checkbox, paste down. Next, I say here D for drawing, chk hobbies, chk drawing, and then I copy this label and paste down. This label is for chk drawing, and class we use form check label. Here I am going to say drawing label should be displayed. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that drawing is also displayed, music, drawing, right? So like that we can get the hobbies. Next, I want to get the user qualification. So to do that, we are going to take again a div form group class, and I say here closing div. Inside that I am going to add the label, copy that and paste down. Here I say qualification, and this is going to be a selection box, so I say here SLCT select qualification. So we will be creating a selection box below this, so I say here SELECT select and closing select. Inside that we are going to add options. So to add options we'll use option tag, opening option and closing option tag, and here I say SSLC, value of this option tag will be S, and then I copy this option tag and paste down. We'll say here UG undergraduate, the value we pass U, control V, and here I say PG, the value will be P, and then we are going to link this label and selection box with the help of name is equal to SLCT qualification here, and the ID also we will use SLCT qualification. If I say file, save, go to browser and refresh, you see that qualification text is displayed and we have the selection box. You can see that it has default styling. Let's convert it into block level. To convert it into block level, what do, guys? We take help of the class form-control class. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that it has converted to block level and now it has bootstrap styles, right? That's how user can select his qualification. After getting the qualification, I want to get the address of the user. So what do we do again? We take help of div form group here and a closing div. Inside that I am going to add the label, and here I say address, and we take address using the text area control. So I say here txta address. Next we'll say here text area closing text area tag, and we link both of them. So here I say name is equal to txta address, and then id is equal to txta address, and we use the class form-control so that it should be displayed as block level. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that the address field is created where user can enter address, right? So here user can enter his name, here user can enter his password, here user can enter his email ID, user can select male or female gender, user can select his hobbies, user can select the qualification, user can enter his address, right? Next we ask user to upload his resume. So what do we do for that? We'll create one more div class form group, copy that and paste down. Here I'm going to say label. We'll ask user to upload resume, and here I say file resume, and we'll use input type equals to file, value equal to empty, name equal to file resume. We copy this and paste here, and then here we say ID also file resume, and we use the class here. We use form control file class. Form dash control dash file class is used to stylize file controls. So I go back here. We will use form dash control dash file class here. If I say file, save, go to browser and refresh, you should see here a file control added, right? User can upload his resume by clicking on this button. Next, we will be creating a submit and reset buttons. So to do that, I am going to copy this div class form group again and paste here, copy this div and paste down. Here I am going to add input type is equal to submit, and I give value in capital. I say submit submit, and I'll create one more form group, copy that complete thing and paste down. Here I say reset, and here I say reset. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You should see submit and reset buttons created using HTML. Let's convert them into Bootstrap buttons. So we use class of btn, and then I say here btn-primary to apply the blue background color. Same class I am going to use here also. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that nice blue buttons are created. Let's make them block level. So what do we do, guys? Here we are going to use btn-block class. We use btn-block class. It converts the button into block level. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that they stretched 100%, right? Next, what I want actually is I don't want these buttons one below another. I want them to be side by side. How do we do that? To place these controls side by side, we take help of grid related classes. We are going to discuss about Bootstrap grids in detail in a future video tutorials. At present, we are going to understand form-row class and call class. Form-row class is used to create rows inside a form, and call class is used to create columns inside a row. So I go back here. What I do in this place, I say here opening div, and then I say closing div. Okay. And then I use the class here, form-row class. So what happens? It creates a row inside a form. And this form group, I'm going to convert it to one column, and this is going to be one more column. Automatically, this will be of 50% width. Automatically, this will be of 50% width of the row. You can see that automatically two columns are created, right? In one column we have submit button, in another column we have reset button. So that is how you can create a row inside a form, and you can place the elements in column. Next, what I want is I want the gender and hobbies should be placed in columns. So what do? We follow the same method, guys. Okay. I'll just minimize this code here. Okay. Next, I come to the gender and hobbies form groups. So here we have the gender form group and hobbies form group. So what do we do? Before this I am going to add a div, and after this I am going to add a closing div tag, and then I use the class form-row, and then to this form group I add a call class. Here also I add a call class. If I save file, save, go to browser and refresh, you can see that gender and hobbies are placed one beside another. Similarly, I want to place username and password one beside another. I go back here, we follow the same method. So what I do here, I come to this place, here we have username and password fields. I say here div, opening div tag and a closing div tag here, and then I use the class form-row, and to this form group I add call class, to this form group I add call class. File, save, go to browser and refresh, you can see that username and password fields are placed one beside another. So that is how you can create forms in Bootstrap. We can also validate forms in Bootstrap, guys. To do validation, we take help of needs validation class, valid feedback class, and invalid feedback class. We see that, I go back here, at present our form is validated by default form validation method. If I go here, I can say in this place, this text field, what we have username, is a required field, REQUIRED, required. What is the meaning of that? If I submit, this control must and should have a value. If this control has no value, then the form will not be submitted. Let's see that. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. If I try to submit the form, you see that it is telling, please fill out this field. This is done by the browser. The default validation method is followed here. If I go back here and say for password also required, REQUIRED, required. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. If I say submit, it is telling please fill out this field. I say here Manju. Okay, this is having the value, but this has no value. If I submit, it says please fill out this field. So this is default form validation, guys, that is happening here. We can stop the default form validation by using no validate attribute. What we can do is, we can go to this form tag, okay? We can add no validate attribute. If I click on the submit, you can see that the form is not getting validated because we have used this attribute no validate. Now we can validate the form with the help of Bootstrap. So what we can do is, we can add a class here, we can say class, and use this class called as needs-validation class. Here I say needs-validation, and next thing what we have to do is, we need to add the valid feedback and invalid feedback. Here I am going to add a span tag, opening span and closing span tag, and we use the class here valid-feedback, and here I say text should be displayed valid if this control contains a valid value, and I copy this code and paste down. Here I say invalid feedback, here I say invalid, please enter your name, and same thing, I'm going to copy this code and paste for the password also. The valid feedback will be valid, invalid feedback will be please enter your password. I say this. To validate the form using the Bootstrap, we need to add a JavaScript code here at the bottom, guys. And that JavaScript code I have already copied here. I am going to paste that JavaScript code. I copy this script code from here. this code you get in the Bootstrap website. I'm going to paste that code here at the bottom. I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. Now you should see the form validation happening. If I try to submit, it gives you an error message saying invalid, please enter your name. Why we got this message? Because this text field is a required field. We must and should have a value here before submitting. I say here Manju, you can see that it is showing the valid text. So this valid text is this text, guys. This text is getting displayed. If this form control has invalid value, this text is getting displayed. Understanding? So that is how the form validation works in Bootstrap. And if I add password here, you see that it is converted into valid. So that is how you can add a validation using Bootstrap to your Bootstrap forms. I hope you guys have clearly understood. I think for this video tutorial, this much is enough, friends. I suggest you people to watch this video again and again, understand everything clearly. Try this code yourself, experiment with more examples, try understanding it again and again, practice again and again. In the upcoming video tutorials, we are going to discuss more about Bootstrap. For more benefits and be up to date, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to like, comment and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. Thank you guys, thank you very much. See you in the next tutorial. Thank you.